Wow.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology. And today is like a festival. Nitin ji is here and Anuradha ji is also here. And I think this is the most demanded and requested Nakshatra video. And Janmashtami is also around the corner on 3rd. And so today we will discuss on Rohini Nakshatra and Anuradha ji will be sharing her presentation. And Nitin ji will also be throwing the bombs in between. So, welcome to Exotic Astrology. Thank you very much for both of you coming here. And let's see what is there. And if you want to make any announcements, you are free to make, of course.
Thank you so much, Babaji ji, for inviting me for this special episode on Janmashtami. And as you said, Rohini is one of the demanding nakshatra. Yes, indeed. It is one of the most auspicious nakshatra. So I'm quite eager to listen to Anuradha ji on it.
Yes. Thank you, both of you. It is a special nakshatra for me for many counts. And this session is also very special for many counts because I started teaching nakshatras from Rohini Nakshatra. And from then, I have grown from strength to strength. My first interview was with Nitin, and the first person to interview me was Babaji. So all in all, there are three things happening in the sixth nakshatra.
Yeah,
so I'm very happy to be on board with both of you.
Yeah, even I had also opened this channel on 5th March 2017. That day also Moon was in Rohini. Although I didn't post a video, I posted on 28th, but I had opened it that day.
So Rohini is auspicious for all of us. It is an auspicious nakshatra for the fact that the Yug Purush, that is Lord Krishna, was born in this nakshatra. He was the one who initiated a lot of changes, though these changes have not yet taken the ground that he wished that life would get us. For example, the autocracies that were happening on women throughout was something that he wanted to abolish. He was able to do it to a great extent because the Mahabharata war did see a woman being avenged for the wrong deeds done against her. However, society continues. So we are expecting the Kalki to change things now. Apart from that, Krishna had many a things like the caste system that had set in. That was one of the reasons people like Karna were not appreciated in Mahabharata and they had put side with the wrong. So many a things that he wanted to change may not have changed to a great degree. But nevertheless, he did sow the seeds and he did Vasudeva Kutam, that is the love and the expectation of the entire, for the entire population, is something that he wanted to imbibe in each one of us. So on Janmashtami, if we can to a certain extent open our hearts for this, it would be definitely your love towards your Isht or at least towards Krishna. With this, let me start on with the presentation, please. So, let us see the start. This nakshatra of Rohini is a very auspicious nakshatra because it is a sthira nakshatra placed in a sthira sign. What does that mean? It means it's a nakshatra which is very fixed and it is in a fixed sign. The second pada of this nakshatra of Rohini is in the sign of, again, will always fall in the sign of Taurus, in the D9. That means it is a Vargottam Navamsh. Okay. Yes. And then it is also Pushkar Navamsh. So it is all growth and growth like proliferation. As we come to it, we will be discussing it. But one flip side of Rohini, I should let you know, whatever you sow grows. So if you sow wrong deeds, they too shall grow. But if you sow positive, they grow into thousandfold in positive. With that, Prajapati. Prajapati is the creator, Brahma, who is the lord of this nakshatra. It is a stellar zodiac and it occupies the region of Taurus, completely within the Taurus nakshatra. This is one of those nakshatras which allows, gives so much of its color to the power of Taurus. Creativity, materialism, ability to work real hard, and sustenance because of Lord Krishna comes to this to Taurus because of these two deities associated with Rohini. It is the star of ascent. That means we grow from strength to strength in this nakshatra. And you can see here the five stars of Aldebaran, and it is also called Alpha Tauri. These stars constitute these visible stars are a major part of the nakshatra or the constellation of Rohini. As I have mentioned earlier, the stars or the galaxy in this particular constellation of stars, there are thousands and thousands of stars. But since the stars are so far away from us, they definitely will not be able, the lights would not be able to reach us, or we would not, with our naked eyes, be able to see each and every star. But these stars, their light reaches us. And as any light affects your perception, these two affect your perception and your lifestyle. So they're very important. The power, the shakti associated with a nakshatra. This shakti that is associated with this nakshatra is the Rohana shakti. This shakti gives us a power to grow and to create, as is with Lord Brahma. Brahma is the creator. So anything that he creates is bound to grow. And this shakti gives a person an ability to sow great seeds such that they grow into multitudes. The foundation above is the plants. The plants with their unique ability to grow unbounded. And foundation below is the waters. So you need to feed something to the plants to make them grow. The desire is to attract a lover and unite with her or him. The main reason is of the desire is the result that you see is creation. This is all about fertilization, and this is all about creating, as we have seen. So to create, there has to be a union of the male and the female. And that is why this nakshatra also is said to be one of the most romantic nakshatras. Creative ability to manifest. So we have Mark Zuckerberg. All of us are on Facebook today. This is an app that most of us do visit it 5 times a day. All thanks to this person from Harvard Harvard Technical School. And though the data here is X, that means it's not very, in fact, it's not very reliable. But Rahu, we know, changes 1 degree in 18 days. For it to change a pada would take a lot of time. So that is why I've put in here just to show that this Rahu is also associated with technology. It is also associated with the virtual medium. So many things. And Rahu is futuristic. Rahu is illusion. Facebook, we think we have a lot of friends. Well, that's an illusion. We make friends. We add people on. So this is what Rahu in Rohini does. It gives us an ability to create, manifest on the virtual front. And he is one of the best designers. He's got a massive brain to go with it. And 12th house, if I do not take the houses, in the second house of the natural zodiac, that means ability to garner wealth through this Rahu. Deity Brahma has a lot of features. And these features are available in many a books. So I will not take up much time, go through just one story. And that is born of marriage to Usha and Saraswati. After Brahmaji was born of Vishnu, and he was given the power to create by Lord Vishnu, he creates a lot of people, lot of rishis. He creates Manas Putras like sage Narad. He creates the Saptarishis, the Sanat Kumars. He creates Daksh Prajapati. Rudra is born of him. Agni is born of him. And so many others. In meanwhile, he creates Sandhya. For all who love the sunrise and the sunset, it is much beautiful as compared to the sun rising in the horizon at noon. So, this beauty and this calmness that we see around Sandhya or morning or evening star, you know, sunset or sunrise, is something which is also a creation of Lord Brahma. Brahma, on having created Sandhya, she was so beautiful that he fell in love with his own creation. Sandhya, she was so guilty of having attracted the attention of her creator in that manner that she ran away. The story continues to the fact that through three nakshatras of Rohini, Mrigasira, and Ardra, so it so happened that at last Sandhya immolates herself. But then again, because nature wanted Lord Brahma to have a partner, another partner is created by him, Lady Saraswati, Devi Saraswati. She is also called the Devi of Vag. That is, she's also called Vag Vadanye. That means she is the one which gives us speech and intelligence. She rules over our speech. So for those who really want to have a very exalted speech, that whatever you speak comes out true, you need to worship Devi Saraswati. Then he takes her as his consort and they rule over creations. They are a part of Trinity of the male and the female forces, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, Saraswati, Lakshmi, Parvati. So they are a part of the Trinity of the gods. There's a huge story that follows, and with some inferences, we would get that about Rohini people is that they have a strong libido. When we are clinically looking into a chart, it could also show familial incest. Scandals are galore because at that time of creations, when the gods had been created, when the devtas had been created, the devtas were scandalized that Lord Brahma was running after his own creation in a manner most unsuitable for him. So there is scandal associated of some form with Rohini also. But in Hindi they say, Chand pe bhi daag hota hai. So the best of the nakshatras can also have flip side. As I told you earlier, what you sow is what you will get in multifold in this nakshatra and for a long time to come because it's a stira nakshatra. In a very stira house, in a fixed sign. And you have a strong sense of desire to procreate because already what is the result of this nakshatra is its desire to procreate. Creation is the desire. So a very strong libido or a very strong creativity in either which ways is associated with it. Just on the mark, when we come across the charts of artisans or musicians or people who are creative in nature, you will see that their libidos are also very flippant. Because that can also be varying, and they are not fixed to just one person. Their creativity may vary from person to person. We will see that in many charts. So it's because the mind frame is such, and there's a desire to create does not stop only at being a good artist, at being a very good, you know, musician or something. And on this platform, I would also like to tell you that the Sanatan Dharma has come a long way. In the earlier times, it was said that a lady had the right to copulate with anybody she chose, even if she was married. But in the Puranas, it is given, and even in the Bhagavad, it is given that Shvet Ketu, Rishi Shvet Ketu, when he saw that his mother was attached to a man other than his father, he questioned his father, and his father said, our religion, our dharma allows that, but he wanted a structure in the society. And when he grew of age, he put a barrier on, and certain laws were put so that society could find a structure, society could find certain norms so that children and women and men could live peacefully. However, we have forgotten a lot of rules and regulations, and we are steadily but slowly, probably, but moving on a decline, which is a very sad thing. I mean, we should, that is the reason we should read a lot of our Puranic stories. For those who do not want to read it in Hindi or English or Hindi or any other local language, English is also lit. In English also, there's a lot of literature available. Coming back to different relationships, yes, the Rohini Nakshatra is associated with a lot of different relationships. There's a need to satisfy physical impulses, because this is a nakshatra, again, as I said, believes a lot in creation and love for public display, because there's a lot of show and pomp associated with this nakshatra. Example, Mary Astor. She was one of those actresses who had a career of 45 years. 45 years as an actress. That's a quite a long shelf life. And she had 109 movies to it. She was a quintessential star of her era, and she maintained her career so well that it flowed into the next generation without much ado. She was married to Kenneth Hawkes, and she had an abortion because she, as I said, one of the very strong impulses is desire. Seventh house also shows desire and procreation. Fifth house is definitely creativity and celebrityhood. So we find Jupiter and Mars, the lords of the fifth house, the Lagna lord, sitting in the seventh house of desire with the seventh lord Venus. So shows a very strong physical impulse on her path. She had to have an abortion because of a baby that she had created with somebody else. Then she married a gynecologist, and she had a baby, she had a daughter. They had a very ugly fight over the custody battle, and he handed over a diary in which she maintained all the notes, which were, he termed it as immoral conduct for a lady to behave like in presence of a child, you know, who's to be responsible for a child. It was a much publicized divorce. So this chart in itself shows a lot of public conduct, which is scandals, strong creativity, a very strong celebrityhood, at the same time, sexual desires at its epitome. Mars is the Lagna lord and the sixth lord of divorce and scandals and legal litigations. So flip side also can be seen. Different relationships. Anthony Armstrong, when he was married to Princess Margaret of UK, she was the sister of the present Queen Elizabeth. And Anthony Armstrong was a photographer. So during those days, as back as the 1960s, it was a very, very strong. Now, when Prince's, Prince Harry and Prince Williams, they have also married commoners. But in those days, getting married to somebody who was working as a photographer, and that to a princess, was something very unheard of. But she went ahead and married him. But the married life was not very beautiful. It is said that, you see, it's a Gajkesari yoga in the fourth house of pleasures, bed pleasures. Fourth house is also home, earth and security. But fourth house is also bed pleasures. It is said that he would go after anything that was in skirts. And he also showed, it is written, documented in Wikipedia, that he also showed tendencies towards men. So it is a different relationship, but he was an ace photographer. He was an internationally acclaimed photographer. Jupiter and Moon, Gajkesari Yoga, a very strong moon here. And Jupiter is again Vargottam. It is falling in the second pada, giving him a lot of clout and a lot of presence there. Jupiter is the second lord and the 11th lord for this lagna, showing a lot of money coming up from his profession. Fourth lord is also, fourth house is also the house of throne and masses, and moon is Digbali, or moon gains a lot of strength in the fourth house. So he had a very strong imagination and the creative power. But moon is, as you will see in Virginia Woolf, is one story where we will see she has an ascendant and Ketu. Ascendant is self. She was physically, abused by her half-brothers. And one of them later on went on to become her publisher. A very acclaimed and well-known novelist and essayist. She had a very turbulent relationship with her own sister. And it is said that it also bordered on being a physical relationship. So, huge amount of creativity, huge, and public acknowledgement. But then it also has its flip side. Moon is in the 12th house and Nakshatra Lord, and as per Bhrigu Sutra, 12th house represents scandals, disgrace, secret sorrows, comforts of the bed. We have Burt Reynolds. We have Burt Reynolds, and again, his story is nearly on the same lines. He's dated so many people, and he is narcissistic. Again, there's a story of not getting their due. You know, many a times Rohini Nakshatra does not get their due in place. One of the legends here associated is Rahul Dravid. Rahul Dravid is one of the very well-known, he was known as the Wall, very well-known cricket players. And he always stood by, he had his head firmly on his shoulder, and he always stood by his convictions, and they always came true. However, playing with Saurabh Ganguly and Sachin Tendulkar at that time, the other two outshone everybody. And so he had to play a supporting role, but nevertheless, a very stellar figure with a very balanced attitude in life. So let's move on to the very reason we have met today, for that is Lord Krishna. He is, as I told you earlier, the Yug Purush, the Yugantar, the person responsible for changing a lot of feudal laws of those periods getting it new yug started. Unfortunately, he was not here to give us a helping hand to put it straight. He was not one of those people who just told. He did the needful. he was the first person on this planet to receive a love letter. So when we're talking about Rohini being one of the most romantic planets, he was the reason why Rukmini wrote a love letter, the first love letter that we are aware of in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhavajit, you speak a lot on Bhagavad. So am I correct or wrong?
Yes. That was the first.
Yes, and she sent it through a Pandit and he went to fetch her. So he realized the need of a lady to choose her own partner. The Vedas say that Swayamvar was very much a part of the... Please do not mind the sound coming from the background. I'm sure you can hear that.
Yeah, you can. There's no problem.
There's something, some festival going on. So it's going to get louder. If you don't mind, I'll just pause for a minute.
Nitinji, it is fine.
Haha, bilkul. Koi problem nahi hai.
Start. Yeah.
He was one of those first people to show that a lady also had a right to choose her own partner. The Vedas, Swayamvar, was something that was very much sanctioned by the Vedas. Over a period of time, they had lost its color, its favor. But he brought it back to life, even with his own sister, that is Subhadra. She did not want to marry Duryodhan and she wanted to get married to Arjun. And Krishna saw to it in all his compassion that his sister's wishes were fulfilled. So compassion, large families, is another point to it. Expert and dexterous. He was an ace negotiator. He tried to negotiate things without spilling a drop of blood. I remember very carefully having heard this in one of the Mahabharata series. Draupadi goes up to him and asks him that you're going for a negotiation with the Kauravas, forgetting the way they had molested me, forgetting the way that they had humiliated me, insulted me, the queen, in front of a royal, in front of the entire royal seat.
Assembly.
Assembly. Thank you. So how can you do that? So he said that if you don't have faith in me, at least have faith in Duryodhan. At least have faith in his character. He is always there to help, and especially when moon moves over Rohini Nakshatra, if you call him, he's there. He comes running, and for that I can guarantee that. And he's the king maker. He's multi-talented. But please don't ask me to write that he will give you what you desire. He will give you what he knows is best for you. And later on, you will be very much happy that you did not get what you wanted, but you got what he gave you. He is multi-talented. It is said that there's nothing that on this planet he was not aware of or he did not know. He was so much younger than Karna, but he knew of his aunt's relationship with the sun god and the child begotten to her through sun god before marriage. He knew of everything, but there's one thing about Lord Krishna that these people would also exhibit is the quietness. He would only work at the right time. He would keep quiet most of the times. He had been one of those child who was adopted. So we'll move into that story of adoption. What had happened was that Krishna's uncle came to know that Kansa had come to know that Krishna, or the eighth child born of Devaki and Vasudev, would be the reason of his end. He was by that time very happily, till that time very happily, going to leave his sister and brother-in-law to their palace just after marriage. On hearing what the Dev Vani, or what the gods had to deliver to him, he was so angry, and moreover, he was extremely afraid. None of us are prepared for our end. So he was extremely afraid to meet his end. And that too through a hand of his own kith and kin. So he took his sister and brother-in-law and put them in the prison. Now he started, one by one, the children started coming. So the first child, when he looked at the child, the child was so beautiful and so innocent that he let go of. But Narad Rishi comes in there and says that if this continues, we will not be able to make sure that his bad karmas are up to the hilt, that Krishna avatar becomes a necessity. So Narad Rishi comes and tells to him that if I give you a petal, would you be able to tell me which is the first? If I give you a rose, can you tell me which is the first petal and which is the last? So he's very perplexed, and being a wise man, he understands what Narad Rishi is trying to convey. Then again, he goes into the sabha of his friends, and because he's a demon, he keeps company of the demons. And there everybody convinces him to kill that child. So it is also very important the kind of company you keep. If you keep a company of people like Nitin Kashyap and Bhavaji, you're sure to go big and learn so many new things.
Yeah, in fact, it is said Kamsa's advisors were all the demons. And the Dhenukasur, yes. This asur, that asur, no.
Shatkasur, Dhenukasur, then you have Putna, all of them. So a man is known by the company he keeps.
Yeah, and regarding this, you were telling about Rukmini sending the letter to Krishna. So there's something else also which is sometimes seen with these natives, that they have a lot of patience. Because if you read the 10th canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, there Rukmini writes in the letter that I am not qualified to marry you from any angle. I am not having the eligibility to marry you, but I will still not marry Shishupal.
Yes.
So what I will do is, before I am about to marry Shishupal, I will burn myself.
Immolate myself, yes.
I will take rebirth and I will do this for millions of lifetimes till the time you don't accept me, but I will not accept anybody else.
So, yes. So, that is there's a very strong creativity, and Rukmini is said to be the form of Shri.
Yes.
That is Lakshmi. So, they have in all lifetimes gone through a lot. Anyways, I'll come to this again. See, multi-talented and adoption fostering is so. What happens is when Krishna is born, now Balram by Yog Maya, what happens? Balram, when he's conceived in the womb of Krishna's mother, that is
Devaki.
He is Yogmaya transfers him in the womb of another wife of Vasudev, and she is Rohini.
Rohini.
The very name of the nakshatra, Rohini, and she is staying with Nand Baba and Yashoda Maya in Braj. Okay, and there she is placed in the womb. He is placed in the womb. So when the doctor examines, or when the Ayurvedic Ved examines, he says there is no sign of loss of the garbha, or no sign of the loss of the baby, but still the baby is not there because it has been transformed. So we had transformation to a greater level here. The womb transplant is taken, is physically seen, but there they did it by pure intent. And now when Krishna is born, there's a lot of trepidation in the heart of Kansa. Kansa, all his life had, in the last part of his life, had just one focus, and that was Krishna. Yeah. So he gets moksha in the end because of Krishna. As I have been telling you, this nakshatra facilitates whatever you sow that you reap in multifold.
Yeah, and they also say that if there is a particular area in your life which is totally in mess, which is like wreaking havoc in your life, and you are not yes. able to do anything about it, then you should start solving it from scratch on that nakshatra, because they say that when Krishna was born, it was a jail and there was total yes. chaos. Now, there were so many demons and the earth was like crying. Now, Bhumi Devi was like, oh, when will I get rid of these demons? So yes. then from there, this thing came and everybody was obliterated at the end. All the demons were finished. So it is said that if you work on your weakness on this nakshatra, then that weakness will be finished in due course of time.
Yes. So, so all of us on, this day of Janmashtami and Rohini can start working on a weakness, as Babaji just said. So he is, when he is born, but the parents, Devaki Maiya and
Vasudev.
This Vasudev are so very afraid for their child, unborn child, because at the end of the day, they are parents. So what they do is they decide that they will, they cannot decide. Then God appears before them, Lord Vishnu, and says, don't you worry, accept me as your son and I will see to the rest. So at 12 o'clock, suddenly there's huge lightning and everything, and slowly everybody is just falling asleep. With just these two of them awake, wide awake, and and people entering there, and the Lord entering the lives. So be aware of fact. If you are falling asleep at 12 o'clock on Janmashtami, you know which category you belong. So what happens is that, you know, they allow, they take, he says, just take me away from here. I will be safe wherever you go. So Nand Baba, so Vasudev realizes that he, one of his very close friends is Nand Baba, who is the head of the Gwalas, or the cowherds in Mathura, Vrindavan. So what he does is, he outside of Mathura, he takes the child, and the Sheshnag comes, because it's a lightning. Generally, you will see on Janmashtami day, at least in India, it rains. So there is lightning, this huge lightning, and there's a huge downpour, as if the skies are just going to, it's like pralay. Or it's like simply like, you know, it's the last day on this planet. The skies are so badly pouring it. But Sheshnag comes and he gives a hood. His hood is right over there. And as effortlessly as he's been able to move out of the palace, he has not been able to cross the the river Yamuna. Nand Baba, not Nand Baba, sorry, Vasudev. Why? Because Yamuna, the river, is very, very, she's very anxious, and she's very happy that Krishna, is Lord Vishnu, has finally come to this world, and she wants to touch his feet. So she is at her best. She just is growing up and up and up and up so that she can touch him. And in the process, Vasudevji is simply getting under the water, but he is just taking the Lord's name and crossing the river, which is getting wilder by the second, not even by the minute. So Krishna realizes that she just wants a glimpse, a touch of him, and then she will go sedate. So he, in all compassion, he picked this small little toe that you see here, he puts it out, and then she just touches that, and she goes as calm as possible, with Sheshnag hooding them across the river. He goes to Nand Baba, Vasudevji goes to Nand Baba's cottage, deposits Krishna there. Sleeping next to Yashoda Maiya is a small, beautiful girl. He takes her, picks her up, and he gets her home. The moment he enters the cage back, having informed his wife, he's left the child safe. The moment the lady in question, that is Yog Maya, or the small baby with her, gives a big wail, and everybody around rises up, wakes up. And then Kamsa is told that a baby is born. But when he sees that it's a girl child, he realizes that he is not going to do anything to her because it is not right. But the demon in him provokes him. Here, Nand Baba and, Yashoda Maiya and Vasudev Ji, Devki Maiya and Vasudev Ji are imploring him that is concerned not to kill the baby because she's a girl and a girl was supposed to be very, very weak. But he says, no, she can be also a reason for my... And as he's going to fling her, that's what he did to the six children. He flung them against the wall and he just killed them like that. And when he tries to fling her, she goes up and she takes the rope off. She takes the form of Yog Maya, the very Tripura Sundari that rules the three worlds, or rather sustains, her energy sustains the three worlds. And she says, the one to kill you is already born and delivered. And that is a terrific scene. That is a terrific scene. And she says, now start counting your days, and she disappears. So that is also the Yog Maya, or the yog that is the Maya, or that is the virtual reality that encloses you, is also to be worshipped on the day with Krishna, because she was also born on the same day. She is his power. And so what happens is Krishna is born. Kansa does so many things to him. But what has to happen, has to happen. He is in the end killed. There is a very strong sense of fostering, because Krishna, up till the age of 8, was adopted, fostered by the cowherds, head of the cowherds. He lived the life of a cowherd till 8, and then he came back to the kingdom that really was his. Yeah. He has a very large family, Vasudeva Kutumb. And he responds to family at all times. They protect the loved ones. He had immense love for each and every member of his family. And we are a part of his family. That's the best part.
Yeah, and I think tomorrow is Balramji's appearance, I think. Tomorrow or day after.
Yeah, tomorrow is Satabhihisha.
Yeah, no, yeah. It is said, once one of my gurus were telling me that sometimes people ask, oh, I'm trying to meditate on Krishna, I'm doing this, I'm reading Gita, I'm doing so many things, but still I feel I'm still at the same place. I'm not getting closer to Krishna. Only I'm doing all these things, but nothing is happening. So then what to do? Then he said, before Krishna was born, Balramji was there. And Balramji ensured that Krishna can do everything properly, whatever he wanted. As you said, he yes. had externally protected Krishna from that rain, whatever you call it.
Yes.
So he said that on Balramji's birthday, if you pray to him that, unless you come to my heart, Krishna will not come. So first, you have to come, only then he will come.
Do you know that gets me to a very funny story? Should I tell you here?
Yes, why not?
when in Ram Avatar, Sheshnag has always been born with Lord Vishnu. Okay. So in Ram Avatar, he was born as Lakshman. So when he was asked by Lord Rama to deliver Sita Ji in the forest, at that time she was pregnant with the twins. So he was very, very upset. He said, don't let her go. Then when he drops her to the forest, and then he asks her he says, I am supposed to take care of you, but I have come to drop you to the forest. And that is something I feel very sad and angry about. So I want you to give me one boon, because you are Devi Lakshmi herself. So she says, okay. He says, in next lifetime, I'll be born as the elder brother. Lord Vishnu as the younger. See, so it happened. But the characteristics still remain the same, because Lord Vishnu could manipulate Sheshnag. Yeah. Balram, he could manipulate every time. Then he ordered in that lifetime, and this lifetime he manipulated.
So fact, let's sometimes move on. People say that no, sometimes if a person who is very naive in knowledge of the scriptures, he reads the Bhagavatam and then or even the Mahabharata, then he sees that, oh, Balaramji is opposing Krishna again sometimes. No? He's saying, oh, you killed Duryodhana in a wrong way, but Krishna only told kill him, no? He's a criminal. So yes. The answer to this is very simple, that sometimes in a glass of water, no, Krishna is like sugar and Balaramji is like salt. So to make the pastime more interesting, that Balaramji behaves that, oh no, no, I don't agree to what you say.
Yes, but if there was any one person who supported Krishna throughout his endeavors, that was Balaramji. Okay, so why have we taken Krishna's chart here in this? Because Krishna's lagna is in Rohini, and he also has his moon in Rohini. Moon in Rohini, if any of you read about it, and if you have the chance to do a research on it, you will find that this moon is a very strong moon and it's very fixed. To my knowledge, these people have very fixed ideas and they're very stubborn. They may not show, but that stubbornness is a stubbornness of character. Once they have come to a conclusion, it is like trying to push the rock of Gibraltar from its position. They will not move. So when Krishna used to decide, he never decided it very, very quickly. But when he did, he was adamant. Again, ascendant in Rohini, he has grown from strength to strength. Being born, as Bhavajit pointed out, in a jail. Moving on to live, being born to parents who were from the royal family, to live with, even if it is with the you know, the king of the cowards, not the cowherd, but the cowherds. He lived very affluently, but nevertheless, he did not live in the palace. So we see struggle in his life. He's moved from strength to strength. An exalted eighth lord in the third house. What does that mean? That means he was the one to bring about changes in society, the initiator of changes in society. That's also the 11th lord of contacts in the third house. Any person, any king on this planet needed at that time had contacts, his communications, his convincing powers, his oratory skills were the best. Ascendant in this case just grows, grows and grows. Ascendant Lord in the fourth house. Ascendant Lord is Venus, situated with Sun. Fourth house is masses. Fourth house is appreciation. And it has simply, he had been able to convince the masses, especially the ladies, the men that many times were opposing to him. He got them around and the ladies knew that he was his savior. Many a ladies he has saved. Many a ladies of the royal family. As you can see, the ascendant lord is with Sun, the royal planet, in Leo, the house of royalty. So if we take the example of Narkasur, here in his chart, he has saved 16,000 princesses from the clutches of a demon called Narkasur, who was going to bring them shame. And he gave them his name.